Sun was popping out a little bit, but it's still pretty cloudy. Somewhat kind of the nicest day we've had in a while, I think. Yeah, about just right. I mean, it's 12:30 on a Thursday afternoon, and I don't mind cloudy days, you know? I don't like extreme cold, but I hate extreme heat. I cannot take the heat. I just can't. I've worked in a freezer for the past 5, 6 years, so I'm somewhat accustomed to cold, but heat just devastates me at this point. I can't stand it. Can't stand it. Yeah. Probably gonna finish these two mags off. See if I can maybe tighten up that group a little bit. I mean, because hell, this is about how far away I'm shooting from about right here, beside the boxes of ammo, to about right there. I would call that 10 feet, maybe 3 yards, give or take. Somewhere between there, probably. Yeah, don't know if probably might just finish off these two boxes, or I might just call it quits after these last two mags. We'll have to play it by ear at this point. Let's get you back up in the tree for the creeper point of view. Careful. Careful. I do not want to drop this thing. All right, that looks good. Let's get the ears back in real quick. Yep, there it is. Found it. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and put 17 plus one in the chamber on these two. I love this Masada. When I was at the gun store, it was between a Glock 17 or the Masada. And like I've said before, I'm just a massive, massive IWI fan. I enjoy my Galils. I've got two Galils. There will be future videos about them for sure, definitely. And I just love them. Not a big AR guy. I'm not, you know. I've got one, but it was a good deal. A damn good deal. And yeah, I got it with it had only had about 60 rounds put through it when my buddy bought it. And he bought it brand new with a box of 200 rounds of target ammo. And then when he came and brought it to me, he had the same box minus 60. So I put that box and probably about close to 100 through it myself. And then me and old buddy Guy went out to go shooting one weekend. And I let Guy shoot it first. He shot it. And as soon as he handed it to me, I put one or two rounds through it. And it wouldn't eject. It wouldn't cycle rounds at all. And I just thought, I was like, well, it's probably dirty, because I was out there, I was tossing the mags and straight mud puddles and all that, and I looked inside the chamber and it was just filthy, and I'm like, well, this thing's dirty. And you got to be a little bit more careful with ARs, keep them cleaner and well lubricated. to keep them functioning properly, like all guns, but the AR more so than most, I believe. So went and put the AR back in the truck, and I grabbed my 7.62x39 Galil, and we started shooting it. And I got home, and I was like, oh, I'm going to clean out that AR. I don't want to, you know, get it back clean and functioning again. And I started taking it down, and I dropped the upper off the lower, and the whole front sight and gas block assembly just slid out. Which I should have noticed beforehand, because for that gun to go down like it did while we were shooting it, that should have been a red flag there, but I didn't see it. As soon as I got it home, the gas block, gas tube, everything just slid right out of place. The base pins in the front, it's got the A2 style front sights. The pins had somehow completely walked out, and it came loose and basically took down the gun. And so after a few weeks, I ordered the pins, replaced them, and I haven't shot it yet because, I don't know, I don't like shooting rifles at my berm yet, even though I think it would be fine. But I'd still like to build it up a little bit more. Couldn't hurt, right? But yeah, I'm just more or less, I'm more of a AK, Galil, long stroke, short stroke, gas piston operating type person. I like my AR, it's fun. It's handy. When I get home, I get the Masada and have it laying out, and I get the AR loaded and have it laying out just in case. Because we had some fellers stealing a bunch of cars around here, and I live in a real rural area. And there's been a bunch of car thefts and all kinds of stuff. And about a few days before all these cars started getting stolen, there were some guys pulled up in the driveway late one night, and I thought they just had a flat or were lost or something. So I didn't really do much. You know, it was 11 o'clock at night. I'd gotten up to pee. That's the only reason I noticed it. And then I heard them cut their truck off. And then I heard two car doors slam. And I was like, ah, well, it's somebody, they're lost. They're having car trouble. I'll try to go back to sleep. But then, as I'm laying there in bed trying to go to sleep, I heard somebody trying to jiggle through the door. They were jiggling the handle to the basement door. And, man, I hopped up, and this was before I had the Masada. So, I actually had my Galil by the bed. So, I grabbed it and my phone for a light, and I headed out there just in time to see them pulling out, leaving. I guess they didn't like any of our cars. Thank God, I guess. But, yeah, scary stuff, you know. Hey, even here in rural Western North Carolina, there's still crazy stuff like that happening. A guy at work got his car stolen. He's about 2-3 miles away from here. Old boy I grew up with got his fucking car stolen from a McDonald's parking lot. This crazy stuff. It's a crazy world. But that's enough talking. Let's shoot this damn thing. Yeah, I believe I'm starting to get the hang of this thing. It's feeling a lot better in my hand. I still can't shoot for shit, though. But I'm getting them all on the target. I was kind of being more nonchalant with that last magazine. They're about everywhere. I think I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to drop that target down in the hole a little bit. That look good? Cool. Let's go ahead and do the 17 plus 1 again. Yeah, another thing I didn't know until I got this thing home and started monkeying with it, that it's got a loaded chamber indicator. That little thing, the extractor. Well, I don't know. It's attached to the extractor, so I'm gonna call it that, which I'm pretty sure it is the extractor. It pokes out a little bit, and it's got a little red here that you can see when there's a round in the chamber to let you know, and it's somewhat tactile. You can run your finger across it and feel it. You know, if it's dark or something and you want to know if you got a round in the chamber. But yeah, really, really starting to like it a lot. I mean, I liked it a lot to begin with, but I like it even more now. Yeah, this thing is just too cool. I've handled tons of Glocks, 1911s, all them other little guns that your friends get when you're younger, the Jennings and all that stuff. More Glocks than anything. And I like having somewhat different, unique guns. I most assuredly am the only person probably in this immediate area. I'm definitely the only one with Galils and oddball stuff like that. Not that a Galil is really oddball, but, you know, most people are just like, oh, I'm my AR-15 now, you know, them dang old perk-perk, man, you know, dang old snort-snort, you know, dang old, you know, perk-perk, man. But I do like having something that, you know, not everybody has. And a Glock is also a very practical, smart choice. But I don't know. I feel like this is damn near the same. And I'd say for about 50 to 80 bucks less than just a Glock 17. And it feels better. It feels much better in the hand, by far. Like, definitely feels much better. But you can't deny that Glock reliability, which this thing has been all but faithful so far, and I haven't heard or seen anybody have much negative to say about the Masada. But it is a newer gun. It hasn't been out too long. I mean, it's, I think, March 5th, 2020, right now. And the Masada's been in the States for almost a year, maybe. So it doesn't have necessarily the track record of Glock perfection, but I think it definitely can and or will at one point or time. I don't know. For all intents and purposes, this is a Glock. It's not a Glock, but it is a Glock. It's a Glock replacement. It's a, you know, polymer framed 9mm Glock 19 replacement. More like a Glock 17, since this is a duty size gun, basically. It's full size. But man, I just like the way them Israelis do things. I think they're super cool, man. They make some cool stuff. So I can definitely get behind that. Well, I believe I'm gonna go ahead and clean up, go in, take my medicine, and enjoy the rest of my day now that I'm off from work. All right. Bye.